Welcome to the YMCA Location Tracker Tutorial. One major program at the Central Community Branch YMCA is its after-school program. This after-school program is a staple for the community of Worcester, so it's important to keep the program running smoothly. After-school programs give children the chance to continue their learning, exercise, and socialize with other kids in their community. It's important to ensure that communication among the staff is at its best so everyone can benefit. In order to optimize this communication, the YMCA Location Tracker Application is the way to go. In this video, you will learn how to use the YMCA Location Tracker Application. Let's get started. When you downloaded the application, you should have downloaded the AppSheet app, which creates a shortcut to the YMCA program application that we will be using in this tutorial. To open the application, locate the YMCA Location Tracker application on the home screen of your mobile device. You'll want to click on this icon instead of AppSheet to get to the correct program. When it opens, the application will sync automatically, but you'll want to use the sync button later before you make any changes to the information in the application. It's important to distinguish between child and group in this application. You'll notice on your screen that there is a long list of children. You can change each child's location individually or move a small group of them at once by selecting one or more children at once. Scroll down the list to locate the group's name. For this group, the name you are looking for is kindergarten group. You can change the location of this group in the same way you can change a child's location. Changing this location signifies that the entire list of children have moved. All children under the location with group signifies that they are in the location of the kindergarten group. If a child has a different location, then that signifies that they are not with their group and are in a different location. First, you will want to sync the application by clicking the sync button. This ensures that you have the most up-to-date information. Wait for the syncing process to be done. When finished, the application will open to the kindergarten group homepage. Here you will see a list of all the children in that group. The children are grouped by location, shown in bold, and further sorted alphabetically by last name. The gray number next to each location tells you how many children are in that location. Scroll through the list using your finger to navigate through the list. If you would like to search for a child, click the magnifying glass. Click in the search toolbar that pops up and use your keypad to type in information associated with the child you are looking for. You can type in a name of a child, a health issue, a location, or any string of information that would be in the notes section of a child's profile. The list will filter the results as you type. Click on a child's name to view their profile, or click the X button to exit the search. For this video, click the X. You are now back to the group's homepage with the complete list of children. To view a child's profile, click on the name of the child you wish to view. It will open up to that child's profile where you will see the information on that child under the headings last name, first name, picture ID, location, health conditions, and notes. Some headings are invisible if there is no information for that child. For example, since Michaela does not have any health conditions, the health conditions heading will not be shown when viewing her profile. Michaela also does not have a picture ID, so that is also not visible. Here we will notice Michaela's location is with group. If you wish to delete Michaela's profile from the group's list altogether, click the trash icon. To confirm deleting, click delete. Click no for now. You'll also notice three purple buttons labeled send kids to either bathroom, upper deck, or back to group. Clicking one of these buttons automatically changes Michaela's location. If we click send kids to bathroom, the application syncs, and when done, shows Michaela's location to be bathroom instead of with group like it was previously. This is one way to edit the location of a child. Another way you can edit this information along with other information such as picture ID, health issues, and notes is to click the edit button. Notice when you do this, some information can be edited and some cannot. First and last name cannot be changed and can only be changed on the Google spreadsheet. This information is grayed out and cannot be clicked on. To add a picture to a child's profile, click the camera icon. If you are new to using AppSheet, your device may ask you to grant access to your camera and gallery. Click Allow. The application will then ask you to choose from taking a new picture or using an already existing picture in your device's gallery. Let's try to take a new picture. This opens your camera. try to take a picture. If you like the picture, click OK. Click Retry for now. Then click the back button on your device to return to the options screen. Now let's try to add an already existing picture. This will open up your device's gallery. Choose the picture you wish to use and it will upload to the application automatically. To edit the location, click the drop-down arrow under the heading. Choose the appropriate location from the drop-down menu or hit Cancel to clear the location completely. Click With Group so we can document that Michaela has come back from the bathroom and is now with her group again. To edit health issues or notes, simply click the heading and begin typing. Let's add in that Michaela has a cold and leave that her mom comes to pick her up at 3:45 p.m. every day in the notes section. When you are done editing, press the Save button to save and sync the information. Let's go back to the group's homepage. If we want to delete multiple children from the group list at once, or if we want to move a small subgroup of children to a certain location, we can do so by either clicking on the check mark box or holding down a desired child's name. Select the children you wish to either delete or move locations. To delete, you would click the trash icon just like you did on the child's profile. To move these children to a certain location, you have two options. The two icons at the top are quick options for certain locations. Click the bath icon and the children will be moved to the bathroom. Click the triangle option and the children will be moved to the upper deck. Or you can choose from the quick menu. Let's click the three dots. This is the quick menu. It has five options you can choose from. Let's click Send Kids to Transitioning. The app syncs automatically and you'll notice the children are now moved to the transitioning location. Next, you will add a child to a group. Make sure you are on the group's homepage. Click the purple plus button. Add in the information of that child. For now, let's put John Smith as the first and last name. These are the only fields required to add a child to the list. Everything else can be left blank. Let's change the location of John to With Group. Click Save when you're done editing. The app automatically syncs and brings you back to the homepage. Here you can see John Smith is now a child in the group. There are six groups for the YMCA location tracker. To navigate to another group, click the menu button. Here you will see a list of all possible groups. Click one to go to that group and see the group's list of children. You'll notice that there is also an about option. Let's click on that. Here you will see a short application description. Click the back button. Congratulations! You now know how to utilize the YMCA tracker location application. Please see the application user guide if you have any more questions. An AppSheet user guide, a Google Sheet user guide, and a Google Sheet tutorial video are available at your disposal to learn more about how to edit the raw data in the application and edit the functions of the application itself. Thanks for watching.
Once in your shoes, I said.